And every other Tuesday when City Council meets, the legendary City Council President Jimmy Gill makes an appearance up here. Good morning, Jimmy.
Good morning, good morning.
Appreciate you promoting Cozy TV, too, Lone Ranger.
Oh, I used to watch those
My
shows.
Favorite.
Yeah, everybody, like you said in that little promo, we've seen them 100 times, but yet we still watch them.
Watch them over and over.
Over and over. It's good television.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, what'd y'all do last night? I've got something out of the papers. Doesn't, you know, said y'all did a few things down there. Anything exciting?
Well, most of the thing, we did a tax abatement for Trias. Matter of fact, they've been adding about $6 million addition.
All right.
Gonna hire some more people, so good for the economy, good for the city, and everyone else.
Good all the way around.
Man, you just mentioned something about that we were there Saturday morning and Saturday afternoon downtown. It's good when events like that draw so many people down there on such a beautiful day.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I was talking to Richard Martin yesterday. We were together, and last week had over 400 people come through city and the county on a bike trail, rails to trail.
Really?
He had a Western group. They had a motorcycle group. And they had about four different groups.
On the trail?
On the trail and all. In all, it was like 400 and some people.
That is awesome. That Richard's awesome. One of my favorite folks and does just a good job promoting everything.
Yeah, and this weekend, not only about the rodeos coming up, you know, during this week, but we got about 32 teams going to be playing ball at Sportsplex this week. Ben Wilder told us last night.
That's good, too.
They got all the hotels already just about
filled. Now, aren't we also, the city of Athens, aren't they expanding the Sportsplex?
Yeah, yeah, we're going to build another part of the field. Run our room, not run our room, but ball field.
Ball field.
Yeah.
Right, let me ask you about something that's popped up recently, thanks to Scottsboro, Alabama. What's the city of Athens going to do about Sunday alcohol sales?
Well,
when do you feel, as city council president, that would become up for consideration here? Serious consideration.
I think probably maybe next year sometime. What we're trying to do is hear from the community, business people, and all, you know, the ones that affect and everything, the business people and all.
Will that be something, there won't be a vote on that by the public, will it? Well, is that something the city council can do like Scottsboro did without a vote?
Well, you can do it that way. You know, you can ask the legislature to get your vote, give the council authority to do it or whatever. So,
what do you feel is the best way to do it?
I really feel like it's the best way maybe to do it like we did the alcohol referendum.
Let the people vote.
On, you know, and everything.
What else happened to City of Athens? You ain't supposed to tell me, but you're about willing to. Got any new restaurants? Any more industries coming in? Is that big one going to be announced anytime soon?
I don't know. They still have it undercover.
But you know.
He's trying, Jimmy.
No, I don't know. They won't tell us.
All right, anything else we need to know about the great city of Athens? What's going on?
We reappointed some people back to Industrial Board last night. Tom McAllister, one of them, she was just telling me about Tom, and I wish him well. Hope
he goes in tomorrow.
Yeah.
Sure does.
Yeah.
You have a birthday to announce?
I got a special birthday to announce this morning. One of my best buddies in the world, little Roy Williams, turns 60 years old today.
Roy Williams, the healthiest 60-year-old
you'll ever know in your life. And Roy, be with us tomorrow as we celebrate his 60th birthday.
So if you see him out today, tell him happy birthday.
And I guarantee you there ain't a healthier man at 60 years old than Roy Williams.
Pretty healthy. Yeah.
All right, Jimmy, thanks as always for coming up.
All right, I'd like to say one other thing. You know, if people see our police officers out and about, maybe just stop and tell them how, you know, thank you for what they do. I mean, they do a lot of stuff people
don't.
You know,
you're exactly right.
They
I just
sure
did a
do.
Thing in the beginning this morning about what that woman said in Hattiesburg, Mississippi. You saw that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Got them.
Yeah, I saw that.
You believe that? What if, you know, I think more police officers were killed this past year than in any year. You know, it's just amazing.
They have a dangerous job anyway.
You know, Floyd and them do a super fantastic job here in the city of Athens.
Yeah, Chief Johnson and his officers, they do a good job. You know, like I said, people just, they ride through the neighborhood, just stop them, introduce yourself to them, give them a glass of tea or Kool-Aid, not donuts or whatever.
you know, and tell them.
Thank them for what they do.
Thanks for bringing that up.
I mean, you know, they just like we are, this American making a living, taking care of their family.
No, they're better than we are. They're putting their lives on the line for us.
That's a good point, Jimmy. Thanks for bringing that up. I got time to run a couple of minutes of the parade, and we'll get back to it later this week. So we talked about the rodeo. More footage from Matthew down there, too, at Chick-fil-A Race. Let's go out here on this Tuesday morning, and don't forget, Gloria will change the weather forecast by the weekend. Don't forget I'll be on Channel 31 Friday with the new Country Rover stories. Y'all make sure y'all
way back
know
week.
That. That's right, way back week. Let's go out with a little bit of that video from downtown Athens. This was Saturday afternoon around 2:30. We'll see y'all tomorrow.
Bye.
That's good. I need to bring this up.
I'm going to go.